Shalom. Once again, it's the voice of Brother Taz Adab coming to you through the spirit of Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh Shah. This is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, you can set up a competent attorney and please be advised. This is for educational, informational, and entertainment purposes only. Today's date, according to their calendar, is July 29th, 2012. For the record, I would like to reserve all of my rights according to the Bill of Rights and the Constitution of the Federal Republic. I'm going to continue on talking about the court system and how it works. If you did not watch video one, I highly encourage you to go back and watch that video. Many of you like to jump around, and that's what you actually have done in this system known as the SOAR. Or the SOAR known as the system. You jump around, you skip things, and you don't read or study things in detail, so you miss the essential elements thereof. So, the first thing that accomplished was changing the way a contract was written and enforced. That's what they did first. So, the contract, the federal corporation came up with a unilateral contract. A one-signature contract. To those of you that don't know, a unilateral contract is a contract where that actually only requires one signature. So, in this unilateral contract was signed by we, the people, under penalty for perjury. In their own law books, a unilateral contract is described as a contract written by a lawyer, attorney, counselor, esquire, a lawyer slash attorney, counselor, esquire groups with specific intent for extorting money. Extorting monies from a sovereign in their own war books. Now, that's a unilateral contract. What's a lawful contract? A lawful contract is one with four parts. And I've stated this in previous videos. There's an offer. There's a consideration. There's an acceptance. And there's signature from both parties for the contract. Without both party signature, the contract is unenforceable unless the party who has not signed the contract can get our agreement for a third party appeal, thereby allowing attorney slash lawyers, counselors, esquires, and so on and so forth, and being officers for the court. Now the court can mediate our dispute. So, a demon by the name of Franklin Delano Roosevelt, president for the federal corporations, not the sovereign people. He wasn't a president for the people. He was the damn demon placed in the office, according to the scriptures. So, he wasn't for the sovereign people. People do not have a head over them. Well, let me continue. So, a demon by the name of Franklin Delano Roosevelt for the federal corporation attempted adding more Supreme Court justice, but fell. He then proceeded, as some justices actually would retire or die out, of stacking his like mind, the people on the court, people that thought like him. So on, or by 1938, Erie Railroad versus Tompkins was actually established by the Supreme Court. Erie Railroad versus Tompkins states, where there is no contract, there is no case. Where there is no contract, there is no case. I'm going to say that again. Where there is no contract, there is no case. So, on or about 1939, the Bar Act was placed into the Constitution for the states, for the United States. An attorney slash lawyer, counselor, esquire can only represent a fiction, i.e. straw man, or a corporation. They are always a third party. for any dispute and must get permission for being the third party. They play on your ignorance, people. When are you going to wake the hell up? And some of you still won't get it. Some of you still won't get it. It's a big game that's been played on us. Nevertheless, let me go into some more history. So in 1946, this long-awaited fourth branch of, and I'm going to say without government, in Roosevelt's own words, was passed on to corporate statutes. And it is called Administrative Procedures Act. The act actually changed forever the structure and the methods of dealing with we, the people, passed by a demon named Franklin Delano Roosevelt. Now, old towns, cities, counties, states, school districts, policemen, sheriffs, and so on and so forth, etc., became corporations and fell under Administrative Procedures Act that the federal government would now, through the towns and cities, counties, and states, rule we the people. They rule us through rules, regulations, codes, procedures, statutes. This is color law. They call it law. They created a statute and say this is statutory law. It's color of law. If the sovereign, cedes their rights, the towns of these cities, of these counties, of these states, of New York, or the vehicles used for these accomplishing these deeds. So, rules, regulations, codes, procedures, statutes, all of this color law, without the law, are not law. I was arguing with an ID 10-2 online, and they cited CVC, which are California vehicle codes. And they said, well, the law states, I said, listen, that's not law, and you know who you are. That, they are codes, but they beg to differ. And for the life of me, I tried to give them the definition of what a driver's was according to Black Law's Dictionary. I try to give them the definition according to Black Law's Dictionary, what it means to travel, but they still stated that if you're behind the wheel, then you are a driver. Now that's a person that's actually been programmed and is helpless, or is some lawyer or an esquire that wants to confuse the mind of the people. So you have certain people that come into my pages on YouTube and they try and sell you an illusion, because they want to keep you locked into this sword known as the system. So brothers and sisters, these rules, regulations, codes, procedures, and statutes are color of law. They are not law. Laws are passed by legislators. This is true. A bill is introduced into legislature and the House hears the bills, votes for its enactment, then the Senate then goes through the same procedure, and upon approval for both bodies, it is signed and sent for the government signature. Now, when the governor signs the bill, it becomes what is known as law. If it is found in violation for the Constitution or the rights for the people, it is struck down and does not become law. And you people need to become a voice again. You allowing these things to be passed and they're saying that, well, this is law. Well, you allowed it. So the legislator cannot pass a bill that violates we the people rights for liberty, life, and the pursuit of happiness and property. As towns, cities, county, states cannot pass laws, only rules, regulations, codes, and statutes. So I hope you're clear on that. How much time do I have? Got a little more time, about 4 minutes. So, brothers and sisters, on or about 1972, the Uniform Commercial Code, called UCC, was made the supreme law of the land over the banking system, and the courts were all put into one court. Now, they would now rule as civil admittee, civil meaning commerce or contract. Now, I want you to keep in mind that UCC deals only with commerce and contracts. So the courts being set up as administrative or admittee, meaning commercial contracts, tribunal has nothing to do with law, only with contracts and commerce. The courts can only try created fictions or corporations, as they have actually exclusive subject matter jurisdiction over the same. The courts actually presume you are a corporation and will proceed against you as a corporate fiction. Therefore, you actually must challenge subject matter jurisdiction. This is why I tell you, don't go in arguing the merit of the case. Argue subject matter jurisdiction from the very beginning. Don't make a plea. When you plead to the court, grant common law subject matter jurisdiction. Don't make a plea. When you go in court, you're going to argue subject matter jurisdiction. Are you clear on that? So, brothers and sisters, you cannot give your name or enter a plea. I'm going to continue this on in the next video. Once again, my name is Brother Tazadok. Shalom.